Cardiopulmonary anatomy and physiology refers to the structure and function of the heart and lungs, which are pivotal in the circulatory and respiratory processes of the body. This field is crucial for understanding how oxygen is transported throughout the body and how carbon dioxide, a waste product, is expelled. This video covers the medical definition and provides a brief overview of this topic. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. Starting with the anatomy, the heart, a muscular organ located in the chest, functions as the pump for blood circulation. It consists of four chambers, two upper chambers called atria and two lower chambers known as ventricles. The right side of the heart receives deoxygenated blood from the body and pumps it to the lungs for oxygenation, while the left side receives oxygenated blood from the lungs and pumps it to the rest of the body. This process is aided by a series of valves, the tricuspid, pulmonary, mitral, and aortic valves, which ensure unidirectional blood flow. Additionally, the heart's electrical system, comprising nodes and specialized conduction pathways, regulates the heart rate and rhythm, ensuring synchronized contractions of the atria and ventricles. The pulmonary system, which is made up of the lungs and airways, is essential for gas exchange. The airways include the trachea, bronchi, and bronchioles, which serves as conduits for air to reach the alveoli, the tiny air sacs in the lungs. In the alveoli, oxygen from inhaled air diffuses into the blood, while carbon dioxide from the blood diffuses into the alveoli to be exhaled. This exchange is facilitated by a thin barrier known as the respiratory membrane and is driven by differences in the partial pressures of gases. The circulatory system, closely linked with the heart, is made up of arteries, veins, and capillaries. Arteries carry oxygen-rich blood from the heart to tissues, while veins return deoxygenated blood to the heart. The capillaries are small blood vessels where the exchange of oxygen, carbon dioxide, nutrients, and waste products occurs between blood and tissues. Physiologically, the heart and lungs work in tandem to maintain homeostasis. The heart's pumping action is critical for delivering oxygenated blood to tissues and organs and for returning deoxygenated blood to the lungs. The lungs' function in gas exchange is integral to providing oxygen for cellular metabolism and removing carbon dioxide, a byproduct of metabolism. This interdependent relationship is finely regulated by neural and hormonal controls. For instance, during exercise, the sympathetic nervous system increases heart rate and respiratory rate to meet the heightened oxygen demands of the body. Moreover, cardiopulmonary physiology encompasses the concept of cardiac output, the volume of blood the heart pumps per minute. Cardiac output is determined by heart rate and stroke volume, which is the amount of blood pumped by the left ventricle with each beat. Variations in cardiac output are essential in adapting to different physiological states, such as exercise or rest. But, as you can see, cardiopulmonary anatomy and physiology represents the integrated structure and function of the heart and lungs. This system is fundamental to the body's ability to sustain life through efficient transport of oxygen and removal of carbon dioxide, which is vital for processes like circulation and respiration. Understanding this system is essential, not just in biological context, but also for medical and health-related fields, offering insights into various cardiopulmonary diseases and their treatments. If you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. Just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.